folks, Kieran at Guitar Guitar here, and today I just want to give you a quick little overview on Eastman guitars. Now, we've had Eastman for a little while now, and they have, as soon as they arrived, basically they became one of our favourite acoustic and electric bands, funnily enough, but we're just here to talk to you about the acoustics today. Just a quick overview for anybody who isn't familiar with Eastman guitars. Now, originally they did start out as more of a folk brand, you know, selling mandolins, some banjos, some other kind of bits and bobs as well, if you're in that circle. We predominantly deal with the acoustics and electrics, but if you are into your folk side of things, then definitely check them out for that. Eastman's workshop is based in Beijing, China, where they create all of their instruments. And today we're just gonna take a quick look at a few that I'm surrounded by right now. Starting with this E40OMTC. Now the TC part of that name is probably the most important topic that we're going to touch on today. What the TC stands for is thermal cured. Now, what that essentially means is a process that involves kind of cooking the woods, you know, removing all the moisture out of it. In the grand scheme of things, what it will do is it will actually kind of naturally age the wood in your guitar. There's a phrase that gets thrown around a lot when people talk about, you know, all solid acoustics and especially vintage acoustics, that it has a played in feel. Now what that essentially means is that the wood over time has just had a chance to expand and contrast and move and just age, you know, much like anything really. Now there's no real easy way to describe that. I think the best way to actually experience it certainly is to have the guitar in your lap. One thing that I really can't overstate with these guitars is there's a tremendous resonance and there's a real kind of feeling that happens with one of these guitars in your lap. The best thing I can describe is if you've ever tried a sustainer pickup or an Ebow or something where the note just keeps resonating and resonating and you can actually physically feel it kind of going through the guitar body. That's exactly what I'm experiencing with these guitars. Spec-wise, what we're looking at, it's pretty similar across the board here. As mentioned, it has this guitar and this one to my right here, both have the thermal cured tops on them. This model doesn't, but it's just a really nice orchestra model. I just wanted to show off too. This model here, obviously a bit more flashy, and it does have an OM style. So, you know, finger picking will sound great on that, but it of course will sound absolutely fantastic with a plectrum as well. Really full bodied, and again, just that feeling that happens with these guitars while you're, especially as I've let that chord ring out there, you can really feel the resonance going all the way through the body, and the note bloom that happens with these as well is absolutely incredible, which of course probably is helped by the fact that all the bracing in these guitars are hand scalloped out in the Beijing workshop. There is just a real level of class with these guitars too. The feeling of them, just the way they look of course as well, is you can tell that a lot of work and care has been put into these instruments. Certainly when you get one in your lap, you're comparing these to maybe some of the more well-known or, you know, potentially more famous guitar brands, acoustic guitar brands certainly out there. For me personally, these stand up with them every day of the week, definitely. It's, again, I can't stress enough to get one of these in your hands, try it out, see how it feels. Let's move over to the dreadnought here, and this model being the E20DTC. Again, the thermal cure top on this one. This one is a little bit more understated, you know, not, it has a little bit of the herringbone binding just on the outside there, which looks absolutely stunning. A non-bound fingerboard, you know, less flash, less bling, I guess you can throw at your acoustic guitar. This one still has an Anirondack spruce top, all solid mahogany back and sides on this. Ebony fretboard and bridge there, you know, you're looking at absolutely fantastic quality parts with this. Let's give this one a little listen, see exactly how it sounds. And I could probably say my entire next part here with this still resonating, which when we anyway hear that might get a bit confusing for the YouTube video, but yeah, the dreadnought here being the much bigger body, as you would expect. A lot more low end, a lot more resonance through the whole thing as well. I feel like I'm saying that quite a lot in this video, but that's the main thing that really needs to be kind of pushed forward with these guitars, is they ring for days. And just, you know, as you play and as you sort of react to how the guitar sounds, it can be incredibly inspiring. It's just, I don't want to put these down. I would play these all day if I was allowed to, but unfortunately I've got stuff to do. The dreadnought body here comes in a variety of options as well. You can get electronics in them, you can get different finishes. There's some slope shoulder models as well if you do prefer the sort of pre-war golden era acoustic guitars that people hold up to such a high standard. That's another good point to make with the thermal curing of these guitars as well. As mentioned, they give that played in feel. That sort of sound is very reminiscent of a lot of older guitars and a lot of, again, pre-war, golden age, whatever you want to call it. The Eastman process of thermal curing is the closest you can get without actually going vintage or custom shop. The absolute standard to which these instruments come out of the factory is absolutely fantastic. And again, just get one of these in your hands, see how they sound, see how they react. You know, they have an absolute plethora of different body shapes to suit any style of playing, or, you know, whatever kind of acoustic that you really gravitate towards. Personally, I much prefer the OM style there. You may be a dreadnought fan, but I think across the board, you will definitely find an acoustic that leaves you inspired, will really not let you down as well. I've seen several people playing these live and they sound absolutely fantastic. And then, yeah, just, you know, knowing that you have a really well-built quality instrument in your hand, I think is just, it is a really good feeling. I mean, what's not to like? And how could you not compare these to, let's say, some other acoustic brands out there? To kind of summarize, if you are looking for, you know, American style acoustics, anything that has a bit of a vintage flair to it in terms of sound, but something that's going to be incredibly reliable, then definitely give Eastman a check out. Get a few in your hands the next time you visit one of the guitar stores, and you may surprise yourself as much as I have with how much you do enjoy sitting with these guitars in your lap. I've been Kieran at Guitar Guitar. These have been Eastman Guitars. Give us a shout on our socials, on Facebook, TikTok, Instagram, Twitter, or even our live chat on the website for anything to do with acoustics, Eastman, or just guitars in general. Thanks very much.